Welcome back students. The next topic in the nucleic is that is alpha decay. Okay, here alpha decay nothing but the emission of helium nucleus. Helium nucleus only emission of the during the nuclear disintegration. Okay, I already told that what is nuclear disintegration. The nucleus goes on decreasing day by day. Okay, this is an example that is X here, X represents symbolic representation of parent nucleus. Okay, this is that represents the atomic number, A is the atomic mass number. When this parent nucleus goes on nuclear disintegration, that is the alpha decay, it becomes daughter nucleus. Okay, with the emission of helium. We already know that helium has the atomic number 2, mass number 4. Okay, this Y represents the daughter nucleus. Here, the daughter nucleus is, in this daughter nucleus, the atomic number is decreased by 2. Here, atomic number is decreased by 2. Then, mass number is decreased by 4. Here, helium nucleus emit agutte. Helium 2 atomic number, 4 mass number. Hence, this daughter nucleus is decreased by atomic number 2 and mass number 4. For example, we are considering uranium. Uranium has atomic number 92, mass number 238. When this uranium nucleus goes on nuclear disintegration, nothing but alpha decay, during this, helium nucleus is emitted. Okay, when nucleus is helium nucleus emitted, the daughter nucleus is thorium. Now this thorium is decreased by atomic number 2. Here 92, Z minus 2 means 92 minus 2, that is 90. Here atomic mass number 230. Okay, here mass number is 4, 230, 230 plus 4, 234, 238. In order to satisfy the equation. Okay, this is an example for alpha decay. Okay, next concept is the disintegration energy or Q value of the nuclear reaction. Disintegration energy of Q value. This is the difference in the initial mass energy of the radioactive substance and total mass energy of the decay product. Initial nothing but this is the initial. X is a parent or initial. Now, next one, difference in the initial mass energy, then total mass energy of the decay product. This is the product. The total mass energy is nothing but My and helium nucleus. It is denoted by the Q. Okay, Q is equal to, we know that energy is equal to P is equal to mc square, where A is the mass. Here, mass energy is nothing but initial mass energy minus and the total product mass. Mx represents the initial, it is a parent nucleus, Mx minus. Here My nothing but a daughter nucleus. M alpha nothing but a helium nucleus. Here initial is X, Mx minus final product is My minus M alpha. This represents the, and C square, we can multiply by this C square, because energy is equal to E is equal to mc square. This is a Q value of disintegration energy of a radioactive substance. Now, here we have another decay, that is beta decay. In the beta decay, we are having two types. First one is positive beta decay. Second one is negative beta decay. These are the types of beta decay. Okay, first one is positive beta decay. Positive beta decay, it is a process of emission of positron. Positron nothing but the electron having the positive charge. During the nuclear disintegration, the positron is emitted, along with the neutrino is also emitted. Neutrino is a elementary particle, like neutron, proton, like that. Neutrino is also a particle. Now, in this reaction, that is X represents the parent nucleus with atomic number Z and mass number A. When this parent nucleus goes on positive beta decay, the Y represents the daughter nucleus. This daughter nucleus, in this the atomic number is decreased by 1 and mass remains constant, along with the emission of positron. Positron nothing but a positive charged electron along with the nucleus is emitted. This is a representation, but here I consider one example, that is sodium. Sodium has the atomic number 11, mass number 22. This sodium nucleus goes on beta decay, a positive beta decay. It becomes neon. Neon has a here Z minus 1, I think what 11 minus 1 is 10, mass number as it is 22, along with the emission of positron, here 10 plus 1, here 11. Okay, equation is satisfied, along with the elementary particle neutron is emitted. Okay, here the sodium goes on positive decay, converted into neon, the atomic number is decreased by 1, mass remains as it is, along with the emission of positron and neutrino. And also we are considering another example, that is proton. When the proton is converted into neutron, along with the emission of positron, with the emission of neutrino. Okay, this is also under the process of positive beta d. Now second one is negative beta d. Negative beta d is nothing but it is a process of emission of electron. Here the positron is released, but here the electron is released along with the emission of antineutrino. Neutrino is an elementary particle, in contrast with that antineutrino is present. Now here the X represent the parent nucleus. This has the atomic number Z and mass number A. This parent nucleus goes on negative beta decay. Here the daughter nucleus is obtained. This daughter nucleus has the atomic number is increased by 1, but mass remains constant along with the emission of positron and the antineutrino. For example, phosphorus, it has the atomic number 50, mass number 32. This phosphorus nucleus goes on negative beta decay. It is converted into sulfur. I already told that the atomic number is increased by 1, that is 15 plus 1 is 60, but mass number is remains constant, but with the addition of electron, here 16 minus 1, 15. Again, the equation is satisfied. And another example is also the neutron. When neutron is converted into proton, it emits the electron and also antineutrino. This is also under the negative beta d. Okay, next step is gamma decay. Here, it is a process of emission of photon. Okay, photon nothing but it has the particle having the definite energy. Really, energy nothing. Liberate target during the nuclear disintegration. Here X represent, I already told, this is the parent nucleus with atomic number Z, mass number A. This is in this star represent the nucleus is in excited state. There are many states. This is the ground state. This is the excited state. Ego the atom excited state of star. When this parent nucleus goes on gamma decay, nuclear disintegration, it converted into, it is goes into ground state by the emission of gamma photon. Okay, the parent nucleus excited state alli ide idu ground state ge return baruvaga alli namge en aagutte some energy is emitted, that energy is nothing but a gamma rays or nothing but a photon. For example, here nickel is there. It has atomic number 28, 60, mass number 60. It is in excited state. Excited state are there, but excited state is unstable. Only tumba vartu nickel atom irikagala. It returns to the ground state. Ground state baruvaga it emits the some gamma photons or gamma rays. Here this star represent the nickel is in excited state. This nickel represent the nickel represent in the it is present in the ground state. This completes alpha, beta and gamma decay. Okay. Thank you.